Well, new rules around temporary layoffs and severance pay in BC as the pandemic continues to affect the job market and businesses. For more on what those are, let's go to Business in Vancouver's Tyler Orton. Good morning, Tyler. So that August 30th deadline is looming. What is the province proposing?
Well, the province says that it will not continue its blanket suspension of those rules surrounding temporary layoffs and severances. Instead, it's going to introduce a mechanism by which employers, they'll have to apply for an extension themselves. There is a kicker, though. Employees have to agree to that extension as well. And that puts many workers and employers somewhat at odds if they both don't agree to what's going on. Under the BC Employment Standards Act, temporary layoffs become permanent after 13 weeks, after which workers are entitled to severance. We've seen this timeline extended twice throughout the pandemic in a bid to avoid many businesses still closed during this pandemic from going bankrupt if they cannot afford to bring on all their workers once again and then pay out these severances. So there could be a very, very big money crunch coming up for many businesses if they find themselves in a situation of having to pay out the severances after August 30th.
No doubt. All right, Tyler, let's shift gears now to real estate and predictions on these record low mortgage rates. How long are they expected to last?
Yeah, well, the Bank of Canada, it's signaling very hard that these rates that we're seeing for homes and multifamily properties will continue for at least 2 years. They really want to get the inflation target back up to 2%, and that could be a very long time from now. The central bank cut its benchmark rate for the third time this year, and its five-year conventional mortgage rate is down from 4.94% to 4.79% as of yesterday. But some brokers are offering rates as low as 1.66% on a five-year term of at least $300,000 with 5% down. That's making Vancouver-based Goodman Commercial Incorporated describing the situation as quote-unquote free money. And it really is a concerted effort by Bank of Canada Governor Tiff Macklem to stoke the real estate industry and by that stoking the economy here in Canada as well.
All right. Business in Vancouver's Tyler Orton joining us this morning. Tyler, thanks so much.
Thank you, me too.